So here we were looking at how man is a dangerous animal that the zoo in Lusaka, Zambia wants to convey. And I made you to underline that he has realized the wisdom of shifting from a system based on domination to one based on partnership. Means human beings were dominating, but it is not like that. We have to come together, all together, and work for a one cause. Scientists have cataloged, means they have listed out about 1.4 million living species with which mankind shares the earth. Okay, estimates vary widely as they regard the still uncataloged living species. Means apart from man, there are 1.4 million types of living organism existing on this planet earth, where man only feels he himself is living in the world, but it is not like that. And that 1.4 million are listed. And what about all those species which are not listed? The scientists have not able to find it out. And here we can see that estimates vary widely as regards still uncatalogued living species. Biologists reckon that 3 to 100 million living species still languish unnamed in ignominious darkness. Means still there are many more species about which human beings are not updated or aware of. Okay, one of the early international commissions which deals inter alia, means international commission which deals among themselves with the question of ecology and environment, was the Branded Commission, which had a distinguished Indian as one of the members, Mr. L. K. Jha. The first Branded report raised the question, are we to leave our successors a scorched planet of advancing desert, impoverished landscapes and ailing environment? So now here we have a talk on one of the commission called as Branded Commission, and this commission raised a very, very important question. So the another fact we are going to study about is BRANDT, Branded Commission, and this commission is raising one question. What that question means? That question states that as one of the Indian was a pioneer member in this commission, and the report raised one very important question, are we to leave our successors? Means what are we going to leave for our future generation? What are we going to give our future generation? Are we going to give them a scorched planet? Means a deserted planet where no plants, no greenery, no forest are there. Impoverished landscape, poor landscapes are there. And ailing environment means sick environment, all this polluted environment. Are we going to give our future generation this type of planet Earth? See, it's a very serious thing if we say, if we actually go for a deep thinking process. What type of planet we are going to leave for our future generation? We have enjoyed all the best. We have actually dirtied it. And now this dirty thing has to be passed on to our future generation. We got beautiful from our past generation. Then why not to pass more beautiful thing to future generation? Mr. Lester R. Brown, in his thoughtful book, The Global Economic Prospects, points out that the Earth's principal biological systems are four: fisheries, forest, grasslands, and croplands. So here we are going to study about the four major biological systems of the Earth. Okay? We are going to study about four, this is very important point, principle biological system. And what are those four principal biological system? Number one is fisheries. Number two is forest. Number three is grasslands and croplands. And fisheries, forests, grasslands, and croplands. Croplands are the fourth one. So these are the four principal biological system: fisheries, forests, grasslands and croplands. It is according to Mr. Lester R. Brown, the global economic prospects. So fisheries, forest, grassland, croplands. These are the four principal biological system and they form the foundation of the global economic system. Okay, and because of this, they form the basic economy. Whatever economy of any country is actually dependent on these four systems: fisheries, forest, grassland and cropland. So these four principal biological system, if it is disturbed, then definitely the economy of that particular country and definitely economy of the earth will be getting disturbed, as overfishing is going to destroy the ecological balance. Oh, forest, then there will be no forest, overcutting of the forest, definitely it will be having effect on the economy. Grasslands, if grasslands are overgrazed, it is going to have an effect on economy, and if croplands are affected, then economy is being affected. In addition to supplying our food, these four systems provide virtually all the raw materials for industry except minerals and petroleum derived synthetics. Means apart from making the, means a part of economy, why it has been considered? Because these things are not only the foundation of our, or they are the source of our food, okay? But they provide raw materials also for all the industry apart from the, just leaving, if we leave the mineral industry and if we leave that petroleum industry. In large areas of the world, human claims on these systems are reaching an unsustainable level, a point where their productivity is being impaired. Means the point of discussing the four major biological system is that now that sustainable development in these four fields, the concept of sustainable development should be followed. But nowadays the concept of unsustainable development is being followed. Means everything is being used at a stake. Nobody is thinking that what is going to be preserved for future. There is overfishing, there is overcutting of the forest, there is no conservation of forest land. Grasslands are overgrazed and then grasslands are also actually demolished, and croplands, excessive use of croplands, deteriorating the quality of the soil and land both. So that's why when we are not preserving natural resources and we are excessively using, then there is the point comes unsustainable development. We are doing development but at the cost of harming our environment. That is the point has been discussed over here. When this happens, fisheries collapse, forests disappear, grasslands are converted into barren wastelands, and croplands deteriorate. I already explained you that if this will happen, then fisheries, if overfishing is there, definitely there one day the quality of fishes or fishing will be collapsing. Means we are not going to get fishes of good quality, and certainly it is going to collapse. Then forest will disappear, definitely croplands are going to lose its value, and grasslands are also going to disappear. They will be converted into a barren or a wasteland. In a protein conscious and a protein hungry world, overfishing is very common, every day. In poor countries, local forests are being disseminated in order to procure firewood for cooking. And in most of the poor countries, this forest are at the stake because they are poor countries. They don't have good sources for cooking, like gases and other measures like microwave or other things. So they are recklessly destroying the forest and cutting the trees to just prepare the firewood. Okay. And in some places, the firewood has become so expensive that what goes under the pot now costs more than what goes inside it. Since the tropical forest is, in the words of Dr. Mayers, the powerhouse of our evolution, several species of life face extinction as a result of its destruction. So Mr. Mayers, is telling us that in major countries, now the firewood, means the wood which is used for preparing food, has become so expensive that what the food is prepared, it is cheap rather than the firewood. It means they are telling us that the main source of the earth on the earth, the forest, even the tropical forest, are at stake. Means human beings are recklessly, without a second thought, are using the natural resources at a cost of their development or in the name of development, recklessly, without thinking what is being preserved for the future. And in this we see that when the forest life is disturbed, several species are also actually facing extinction. And when several species will be extincted, then definitely the ecological balance will be disturbed. As in our previous, we can see that in our junior classes, we have studied about food web, food chain, and how this food chain and food web goes on. We know very nicely that how one animal is dependent on the other. But if one species is extincted, is not there, then how the environment or the ecological balance will be disturbed, we all know. So this is the thing they want to explain to us. It has been well said that the forests precede mankind, deserts follow. The world's ancient patrimony of tropical forest is now eroding at the rate of 40 to 50 million acres a year. And the growing use of dung for burning deprives the soil of an important natural fertilizers. The World Bank estimates that a 5-fold increase in the rate of forest planting is needed to cope with the expected fuel demand in the year 2000. So it has been telling that how the forests are now collapsing per year, as we are using it excessively. We are using excessively. Okay. And it has been told by James Speth, the president of World Resources Institute, said the other day, we are saying that we are losing the forest at an acre a second, but it's much closer to an acre and a half to a second. Oh my God. Means forests are cut at such a rate that they have even counted the parameters that every second we are losing 1 acre of forest land, or in simple terms, more than it. In every half a second, we are losing an acre of land. Now here something has been talked about, our preservation of the forest. Article 48A of the Constitution of India provides that the state shall hand over to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard the forest and the wildlife of the country. So there is a rule in our country. According to the Constitution, there is a proper rule that each and every state should be performing, the government should be performing the duty to save the environment, to save the forest, and to save the wildlife. But what caused endless anguish is the fact that laws are never respected nor enforced in India. Means they are always ignored. There is always a misuse of the laws. They are never actually given that much importance from the point of environment, from the point of the Mother Earth, from the point when it comes to the saving of forest land. They are never taken as sincerely. For instance, the Constitution says that the casteism, untouchability, and bonded labor shall be abolished, but they flourish shamelessly even after 44 years of operation of Constitution. Like our Constitution also does not or abandoned this casteism, this child labor, this untouchability. Everything has happened. Means all the evil things, social evils, like they're abandoned. Like same, we have a rule in the Constitution for the safety and security of forest and wildlife. Like that particular rules are actually ignored and misused. Still those untouchability, casteism, all are practiced in India. Same. The forests are actually being cut at an alarming rate without taking care that there is a rule nobody is bothered about. Nobody is bothered about it. A recent report of Parliament's Estimate Committee has highlighted the near catastrophic depletion of India's forest over the last four decades. Means last four decades, there has been a dangerous decrease in the India's forest parameters, or India's disastrous decrease in India's forest resources. Okay, according to the reliable data, it's losing its forest at the rate of 3.7 million acres a year. Oh my God, every year, 3.7 million acre of land in India, we are losing. It means forest lands are cutted down, forest is cutted down, and that land is being converted into a city, and that we are calling a development. So that development, which is on the cost of environment, is called as unsustainable development. So in India, the ratio is pretty alarming, or shocking, or rather more catastrophic, means dangerous, that every year at 3.7 million acre land is being decreased as we are proceeding with the year and year on. Large areas officially designated as forest land are already virtually treeless. The actual loss of forest is estimated to be about 8 times the rate indicated by the government statistics. Oh my God. Means on the reports, on the paper, we find that there is a forest land, but actually when you go and see, there is no forest land. Such a corruption is existing in India, and whatever data has been provided by the reliable sources or the government of India, the authorities or our writer is stating that 8 times more there is a loss of forest land. So we can imagine how we are irresponsible towards our planet Earth or towards our environment. A 3-year study using satellites and aerial photography conducted by the United Nations warns that the environment has deteriorated so badly that it's critical in many of the 88 countries investigated. Oh my God, if you have seen, like in the USA-based United Nations has done a study in which through satellites and through aerial photography, they have actually found out 88 countries there is a risk of environment. High risk environment is actually being seen in these countries, means not fit for living. Oh my God, there can be no doubt that the growth of world population is one of the strongest factors distorting the future of human society. It took mankind more than 1 million years to reach the first 1 million. The world's population around the year 1800, by the year 1900, a second 1 billion was added, and the 20th century has added another 3.7 billion. The present world population is estimated at 5.7 billion. Every 4 days, the world population increases by 1 million. My goodness, these statistics are really, really alarming. And one of the factors which has been made responsible by the sources is growing population. Means if we would have been able to control our population, then it would have been fine. But it is not like that. The increasing population of the world has really caused many, many danger situations. Like the entire world, 1 billion, it took 1 million years. But now, if you see, very easy to understand the last line of the second paragraph at page number 46. Every 4 days, the world population increased by 1 million. My goodness. फर्स्ट बिलियन तक पहुंचने में हमें मिलियन ईयर्स लगे, लेकिन अब हर चौथे दिन हम मिलियन पॉपुलेशन इंक्रीज हो जाते हैं. 1 मिलियन वी आर इंक्रीज. सो व्हेन, हाउ सिंपल, वी हैव लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेस एंड वी आर ग्रोइंग एट एन अलार्मिंग रेट. ओके, वी हैव दिस मच ओनली. This can be easily utilized, or it is sufficient for limited people. We can say, if this is the resource, 4 people can easily eat it. Like if you prepare a vegetable, 1 kg vegetable, or for 4 people, it is sufficient. But if only 1 kg vegetable is prepared, and in your home, 20 people more comes as a guest, You have to prepare another dish. You have to prepare that 1 kg vegetable is not going to work for 21. Okay, but the same is happening in the world, that the sources are limited and the people for utilizing it is increasing day by day. Fertility falls as income rise, education spreads and the health improves. Thus, development is the best contraceptive, but development itself may not be possible if the present increases in number continue. Although education has been much more there, people are more understanding, people are more aware, still development at the cost of environment is the most harming situation or alarming situation for all of us. The rich get richer and the poor beget children, which condemns them to remain poor. More children does not mean more workers. Merely more people without work, it is not suggested that human beings be treated like cattle and compulsory sterilized. There is no alternative to voluntary family planning without introducing an element of coercion. The choice is really between control of population and perpetuation of the poverty. Means, though there has been a spread of awareness that small families were encouraged in the countries like India, still many of the people, when awareness was not there, they think that more children are going to produce or earn more money. But it is not like that. In this way, if the rich is going to get more richer and poor is going to get more poor, so we have to take a decision. Human beings have to take a decision in the populated countries like India that we need to have smaller families. Okay, that's why in India it was this entire planning of government actually goes on with the fact that they try to aware the country that go for small or nuclear family. That where there was a slogan raised by government, Hum Do Hamare Do. It is for the populated country like India, the world's most populated country like China, where there has been compulsory to follow each and everybody. The family has to follow a simple rule, you will have only one child. That policy that was imposed on Chinese people, our government has been so lenient in our country that they don't want to treat the people of the country like animals, as the people of as the government of China has treated its people. Like, now if it is not being controlled, so we have to control with this measure. But if our government is actually motivating us, trying to aware us, we need to follow it, because it's also not like that. The things will work like that, that there will be compulsion and there will be control in the population. Means responsibility from both sides needs to be taken, both by the government and by the people of the country. The population of India is estimated to be 920 million today, more than the entire populations of Africa and South America put together. Oh my God, our country population, if two countries are even put together, means two continents are put together in one continent, how many countries are there? So our country equates with two continents population. My goodness. No one familiar with the condition in the India would doubt that the hope of the people would die in the hungry hutments unless population control is given the topmost priority. So in this last 2-3 paragraphs, our narrator wants to tell us or give us the message that population control is the first and very important factor which needs to be given, which needs to be focused on very on the priority basis, that if our people of this country should flourish economically, then population, there should be control in the population growth. Okay, for the first time in human history, we see a transcending concern, the survival not just of the people but of the planet. We have begun to take a holistic view of the very basis of our existence. The environmental problem does not necessarily signal our demise. It is our passport for the future. The emerging new world vision has ushered in the era of responsibility. It is a holistic view and ecological view, seeing the world as an integrated whole rather than a dissociated collection of parts. So here also, in this paragraph, our problem is the same factor. Our author wants to tell us that please take this thing very seriously, that the environment or the planet Earth is a living organism, and if we are actually pressurizing the planet Earth beyond its capacity, then the Earth will become a weaker place, it will become a sick place to live, and then our existence will be threatened. Industry has a most crucial role to play in this new era of responsibility. Water transformation would be effective if more businessmen shared the view of chairman of DuPont, Mr. Edgar S. Woolard, who 5 years ago declared himself to be the company's chief environmental officer. He said, "Our continued existence as a leading manufacturer requires that we excel in environmental performance." So there has been a description about Mr. Edgar, who is a chairman of one of the company, and he also declared himself as the chief environmental officer. Means we all know how industries through their chimneys are harming environment. But if certain CEOs or certain directors of the industries take a step forward, that apart from being a manufacturing processor or they are a part of big manufacturing industry, if they do take the environment in consideration, then definitely the world will be better place. As Mr. Edgar says, that if I am a manufacturer, the world will be only be a place for my existence if it actually become a place of existence. I will be existing in this air, in this earth. Otherwise, if it becomes a bad place, I won't be existing. Of all the statements made by the Margaret Thatcher during the years of her prime ministership, none has passed so decisively into the current coin of English usage as her fallacious word. No generation has a freehold on this earth. All we have is a life tenancy with a full repairing lease. In the words of Mr. Lester Brown, we have not inherited this earth from our forefathers, we have borrowed it for our children. So there are two important thoughts coined by two major personality. One is the former Prime Minister of England, Mrs. Margaret Thatcher, and she is stating that we are not having the entire hold on this earth. We have a temporary life on the earth, so we cannot say the earth belongs to us. Entirely means we can dominate the earth like anything, using its resources on a stay. We should take it very cautiously by preserving its natural resources. And the second thought has been coined by Mr. Lester Brown. We have not inherited this earth from our forefathers. Like we inherit property from our parents, like that we have not inherited the earth. Don't take it for granted. That is the meaning of it. It means he is trying to tell us we have borrowed it from our children. Means we have to keep the natural resources that much sufficient available for the future generation also. So here we complete our chapter that states that how this earth is a respectable place to live in, or rather earth should be considered as a living organism. And many approaches we have seen that how one of the things, the four principal biological systems on the earth, we have seen how growing population is actually interrupting its, or rather making it an ailing planet, how various theories people has come across, how fisheries, croplands, grasslands, forestlands are destroyed. We have seen how human beings are the most dangerous animal on the earth. It has been discussed. So before I leave the class, I would like to give you few questionnaire as your homework, and you are going to do it. Your homework assignment will be understanding the text on page number, it is on page number 47. So your homework assignment is on page number 47, understanding the text. Understanding the text, and we can see that first question is locate the lines in the text that support the title Ailing Planet. I hope you are going to do this. I already told you to underline it. What does the notice the world's most dangerous animal at the case in the zoo at Lusaka, Zambia signify? That human beings are the worst, world's most dangerous animal, and it's human beings who are actually damaging the earth. How are the Earth's principal biological system being depleted? There are four principal biological systems: fisheries, croplands, grasslands, forests, and how they are being depleted. I explained you, and you need to explain in your answer. And why does the author R, the growth of the world population is one of the strongest factor distorting the future of human society? I explain you the fact that there is a limited source on the planet Earth, and we are actually the population is increasing. So definitely there will be inavailability of the resources, and our planet Earth will be converted into a deserted, scorched planet with impoverished landscapes and things like that. You need to write in your answer. So my dear children, hope you understand the chapter very well. So till we meet next time, have a nice day. Complete your work, complete your home assignment. Send me through the message option in the study based application. Till we meet next time, have a nice day. Bye-bye.